Hey, welcome back. It is time for sports. Kern County has three Olympians, but entering Saturday, none of them had competed yet. But the first Kern athlete made his debut Saturday, and in a big way. Sprint cyclist Jimmy Watkins, who is a Kern County firefighter with two races Saturday for a spot in the final eight. The race you see here was his first rounder against a Japanese rider. He also beat a rider from the Czech Republic. Those two wins means Watkins is moving on to the final eight. He will race tomorrow, or I should say today, at 8:30 a.m. Pacific time. You can visit our Facebook page, KGET17, for a link to where you can watch it live at 8:30 when and Watkins is moving on to the final four. Olympics history made Saturday in the first round of the 400-meter dash. The first double amputee sprinter ever at the Games made his debut. His name is Oscar Pistorius, and he's from South Africa, but he didn't just compete, he finished second in his heat. The former Paralympic champion moving on to the semis of the 400 meters in London.
I've been thinking about this day for the last 6 years. I missed Beijing by a quarter of a second. To be out here, I'm a 400 meter specialist, and people have often asked me, with this experience in mind, this crowd is amazing. With this experience in mind, would you see yourself as an Olympian or a Paralympian? And I've always just said, I'm a 400 meter runner.
Well, Michael Phelps promised before the London Games that this would be his final Olympiad. If that is in fact the case, Saturday was his final swim as an Olympian. Phelps, a part of the 4x100 medley relay team, four swimmers, each doing a different stroke. Phelps doing the fly. He would then later hand it off to Nathan Adrian, who swam the final leg, the freestyle, and he would give Phelps his 18th career gold, 22nd medal overall. That's the most ever. Clearly Phelps going out on top.
The memories that I've had from this week will never go away, and soon enough they'll be on a piece of paper and in my journal, and I'll have them written forever. Through the ups and downs through my career, I've still been able to do everything that I've ever wanted to accomplish, and I've been able to do things that nobody else has ever done.
On to the women's version of the same event. USA won a silver medal 4 years ago, looking to up the ante this time around. And we're going to fast forward to the final leg. Allison Schmidt not only going to bring home the gold for the U.S., but how about a new world record? Missy Franklin, by the way, part of this team as well. It was her fourth gold medal of the Games. Well, after beating Nigeria by 83 points just a couple days ago and smashing all sorts of records, everyone waiting to see what Team USA basketball would do for an encore. Taking on Lithuania, Carmelo Anthony, 37 points in just 14 minutes against Nigeria. Good game here as well. 20 points in 25 minutes for the New York Knicks superstar. USA up 9 in the second, but in the fourth, Lithuania takes a 2-point lead on the Linus Klaza 3. Do I smell an upset, LeBron James? Give me an answer. LeBron says, no upset. 3-ball gives the USA a 4-point lead. Then he follows that up with what will be a monster dunk in transition. Team USA holds on 99-94. They are 4-0 at the Games. On the track, women's 100-meter finals. Three Americans in the final, including Carmelita Jeter, not Jeter, and Allison Felix. But it was the 2008 gold medalist Shelly Ann Fraser-Pryce of Jamaica repeating as the champion in London. Jeter winds up with the silver medal. And outside of the Olympics, Bakersfield Blaze beat Modesto tonight.
Sounds good. Thank you, Trevor. Yep. We'll be right back.